Hi, this is Matthias here from Windsor.ai, and today I'll show you how you get Salesforce data streamed into Snowflake. Before you start, please make sure that you have access to a Salesforce instance and, of course, access to Snowflake. Let's start. You head to onboard.windsor.ai, and then in here, you search for Salesforce. Then you grant Salesforce access, and once the flow is completed, you're able to select your Salesforce account in the drop-down here. Then you proceed to preview and destination. And now here on the right-hand side, you will have Salesforce appearing in a drop-down. I have more connectors connected. In your case, there will only be Salesforce. You click on it. And as a next step, you will need to select fields. Now, what I have here is a demo instance, which only has records in the contact object. In your case, you might want to select different fields. We also do support custom fields and custom objects. So I'm changing my query to contain contact first name and last name. Again, this is a test data set. For the next step, we go to Snowflake. And then in here, we click on Add Destination Task. Now in here, you'll need to fill in the details. Now I've filled most of the fields here. For task name, I give it Dummy Salesforce Upload. I'll give the same as the table name. And here, important, we create the table on the first upload, so no need on your end to prepare or create any table. Now we also need to select the schedule when the upload will happen. I'm going to set that to 2 a.m. Important, this is in UTC. And then I click Save. And then the data is transferred into Snowflake. Now the upload turned green. And now it's time to go and have a look if the table was created here. And now in here we see the dummy Salesforce upload. And I click on Show Table Records. And now we can see that the data is synced. So now what will happen is tomorrow, 2 a.m., the data is going to be synced again. In case you want to backfill your existing data, say you want to have 2 years worth of data synced over, you simply click on 2 years here and click on Save, and then the backfill is triggered and all your data synced over. What I would also recommend is to create multiple tables, one for each object, ideally, and then you have your data in Snowflake and you can start working with it. Thanks very much for watching and enjoy working with our connectors.